Yeah, thanks. Great to be here. So I would, a small disclaimer at the beginning, I wouldn't consider myself as an expert, but rather as an experienced person in the field. And the topic I want to address today is the consistency in Power BI. So basically the question, how to build and understand Power BI reports more productively. A short overview on Liebherr. Liebherr was founded in 1949 by Hans Liebherr. We have over 13 different product segments. The headquarter is located in Switzerland. We have roughly 15,000 employees over the whole world. And Liebherr is still a family-run technology company. We have a quite unique range of products, from refrigerators and freezers to mining machinery, also luxury hotels. But today, I'm representing the Earthmoving division of Liebherr. We have established a BI Competence Center in 2019. We are 7 full-time employees and 3 interns that have to support, create solutions for over 80,000 employees in the division. And we are currently doing a lot of work in training the Power BI, training the employees in Power BI. The first question I want to address today is, why do we need standardization in the first place? Therefore, I want to reference an article I recently stumbled across by Brent Dykes, who is describing this whole way and this whole procedure of getting from data to action on a company level. And he's using the marathon metaphor. So he's saying, okay, all companies are collecting data, data preparation, and they also visualize the data. But then on the last mile, there is some decreasing percentage. So really the way from data to take action, it's like really hard. And I want to take this bottom line and break this down for the individual and also the company. And I just reference it as, let's say, the value journey from data to action. If there is only one man, one woman, this is no problem. This is the self-service potential scenario. And I want to, I call it the Rob Colley scenario. Rob Colley from Power Pivot Pro was actually the person that brought me to this whole Power BI topic. And I started by reading his book. And he once mentioned in the podcast that, okay, I was analyzing some data for my fantasy football, and I was amazingly fast, he stated. And this is because he was the requester, the developer, and the consumer in one person. So in this scenario, this value chain is easy. No feedback loops, no requirements engineering. The results always meet the expectations and the user as the developer. But as soon as there is some request in your company, so, okay, I want to use your solution as well, the change requests will arise and you start a new journey. And I reference this journey as a BI mountain, or creating and sharing reports. In the beginning, it's clear you want to create a report, weather is sunny and everything is smooth. But then soon you discover, okay, first version of the report, it's not what was expected. And there is a difference between the request of a user, an actual requirement, the expectation of the requester, and the actual need behind it. So this is really something you discover on the way of your journey. So suddenly the weather is turning and you find yourself somewhere in the middle of this whole journey. And the path you're on, it's only visible in hindsight. So you do not know how big, how far the mountain is. That's a big question mark. Therefore, a successful journey starts in the beginning. I call it the standard backpack and the best practice shoes. So be informed and equipped, and be lazy if you want, because it is also very easy to create something out of an existing best practice solution. You know, Zebra BI is providing a lot of templates. Maybe also in your organization is some best practice report you can use, copy, and then just adapt it to your needs. Use conformed data if you have a data warehousing team. Use prototypes and MVPs of your report to get a fast feedback to be on the iterative path. And also know your goal. So the target of climbing a mountain is not the mountain itself. It's actually the way home. So coming home is the target here. And we at Liebherr, we are still somewhere in between these summits, and we do not know how big the summits will be in the beginning, but we know that we want to come home if you want to. Okay, so the first conclusion we can draw, it's basically a movement from left to right. The journey is basically from left to right. And standardization is accelerating the value journey. It's not the target, it's just a method of accelerating this journey. But the harsh reality is that it's not like from left to right, it's more like back and forth. So in usually big companies, you have a lot of different roles and employees that have requirements, are using reports, changing data, do some X and X's magic, and it's very hard. So it's back and forth, and it's more like a maze. Communication is very difficult, and you start seeing this whole topic as a big puzzle. You have to assemble this big puzzle, data preparation, tools, visualization, feedback, and also the requirements engineering. And the number one tool or number one object of assembling the single pieces together is communication feedback. So the best tool is worthless if you do not have a good communication within your company. So that's the key takeaway here. And for today, as you might guess, I just want to pick one piece out of here and try to talk about this Power BI visualization and also using Super Visuals for this. So how can we implement consistency in Power BI reports? As Andre mentioned at the beginning, there is a vast of possibility of creating reports, but how can we narrow this down to the key methods and key aspects? So usually every developer, if this is a business person, IT person, or from some analysis team, they're starting at the beginning on a blank page. And this page layout you have to consider in the front end, in the presentation mode. On the left pane in the Power BI service, you have the navigation pane. On the right side, you have the filter pane. So maybe it's counterintuitive if you put some on-page filters on the left side here. This is given, so just consider this. And then you can divide your page into different areas. We have a header area, a footer area. You can put the logo on the top right and provide some area for functional icons. So back, for example, remove all filters, a link to some more information or documentation about the report or the model behind. This is like you have free in the creativity regarding the functionality, but not on the layout, basically. So that's something. So I always get one manager ask me if we can put, let's say, we have to have creative analysts. And we say, yeah, but not on the design, but more maybe on the functionality and on the insight on the data. Okay, then some important topic is the on-page filter and slicer area. So we decided to put some area there for putting slices and filters there instead of the filter pane or both. So that's a question mark. There is no hard rule. It's more a rule of thumb. So if you have filters that provide interactivity or just a small selection of elements, or maybe something that is used very often, put it on the page. For the more advanced filter functionality, consider the filter pane. But this is also something you have to create based on the feedback you get from your users. Then, of course, the heart of this whole concept is the report canvas. Here, I see also a lot of creativity, and therefore it is important to set standard visuals. And by standard visuals, I do not mean the native visuals from Power BI. So no offense there, but this provides too much choice for the user. And I also did some 3D pie chart in Excel in 2010. Somewhere around this. So the standard visuals should be reduced to the most basic set of visuals: table, matrix, slicer card and add them with some magical and cool additional visuals. And with this set of visuals, I think you can add, you can cover 80% of all the requests. Of course, be sure that the exceptions prove the rule. So if a data scientist is coming with some scatterplot or regression analysis, it's perfectly fine, but be sure that the 80% business management is considered this as the standard visuals. Okay, then I prepared a small example of how to transform a report with this approach. I used the Zebra BI demo dataset and I tried to reassemble some actual reports I got from the business, and it is really looking like this. So this is not far from the edge. I just forgot to put the pie chart here. That would be something, but it's really like this. So what do we have here? If I ask you, I speed this process up, it's about the revenue. I have to highlight this because you do not see this in this area. We see a detailed table on top. You do not need detailed tables in this page. You can provide a detailed page with a drill through. So get rid of this. What do we have here? Filters. Okay, they want to filter the data. We have country, we have some business unit hierarchy, and 1 month selected. So I put this into the top area of the on-page filters. This is how this is looking like in the Liebherr world. For some or most of the reports with Power BI, we have the Smart Filter Pro from SQL BI, the standard slicer, and this is everything. So you see some yellow color here for the filter context. At least we have some meaning to the color here. But still, you have the visuals. And now I do something that you know from Andre's webcasts and YouTube videos. I just add some Zebra magic to it. And you see this is something different. You already have some recognizable patterns. And I also have room for more detail. So I just provide visual by product and by country, so I provide more insight to this report page that is analyzing the revenue. On top, besides the impact analysis, I put in KUSD that you also have some information there. And we have an IBCS conform report. And sometimes I get this from the users as well. Okay, I have a IBCS report in Power BI, it's all black. Doesn't look very good. We want to have colors. That is some statement also on the top management. I said, yeah, you can have colors, but you have to be happy with red and green and maybe some blue. And this is something I try to convey to the business all the time. Please be sure that you add some context to it. Add your previous year comparison, a benchmark, a plan figure. That's so important. It is not only looking good, but you also get some insight additionally. So this is something that is recognized over the management. Sales report is looking the same like the finance report. And now you slowly can build some movement here. Now the report is finished, or is it? So you still can narrow down the range of the line chart. And I also added some footer area here with the last refresh that is very informative. And I got rid of this previous year because maybe we can also save some room over there. And some small hints, so it's all about the details. What I also did is that I got rid of this small K behind each data label because it's already in the header and in the title. So you see transformation of some real life encounter, and I really found it hard. I found it hard to create this before example because I was constantly thinking, where should I put the visual or the filter? It was really inconvenient. If you used to work with Zebra, it's not only easy and fast, but you have to focus, you can focus more on the actual data and the insight. Okay, so what are the fundamentals of standardization in Power BI reports? Therefore, I have to quote Alberto Ferrari because he's always saying, okay, DAX is simple, but it's not easy. It's the same for the fundamentals of standardization here. So you can add and provide some custom theme. We did this. So layout guideline, how to create a report, fine. Set the standard visuals, provide a template file for copy pasting and adapting. Be sure that exceptions prove the rule. and most importantly, feedback and consolidation. But even if you have these building blocks available, there is still the good and the bad. And just to mention one example here, custom theme. We used a lot of time of creating this theme that the user do not have to change or choose colors. We added the CI branding and also some standardized settings for the visuals. And the controller was coming up to me and here's a report, please deploy it. I have used Zebra BI and IBCS. I was like, great. I open up the report and I see yellow as the actual color. And I was asking why? And he said, I don't know. I changed it because it's the Liebherr color. I provided some extensive feedback to this person, but still there is a learning curve. So to this day, I know controllers that never heard about the IBCS. So it's amazing. Or also for the template file, we created a template file with a nice set of examples. And in the beginning, we put the draft version out for 2 power user. And to this day, 1.5 years later, we still get reports with this early draft of this template. So be also cautious that even if you have these blocks available, it's not that easy. And for summing up my short presentation, I want to provide you with some key takeaways. So first of all, I already mentioned it, standardization is not a target. It accelerates the value journey, speed, and also the quality. Creating reports does not add value. Only the application provides this. So this is a reference to this last mile or way home metaphor. Use what's already there. So it's often easy to just copy paste and adapt stuff on existing solutions. The tools or BI tools and Power BI alone won't solve these challenges and issues. Always try to identify the real need. So this is the main challenge. If you have to be if you want to be productive and effective, because this point reduces your feedback cycles. And can't emphasize enough feedback and consolidation. And last but not least, please do not use any pie charts. So that would be my last point here. And if there are some questions you want to address, I'm happy to discuss this in the Q&A session, and I'm happy that the technical issues in the beginning was just a small challenge.
Well, thank you, Mario, for an informative and entertaining presentation. It was really a pleasure to listen to you. And everybody, don't forget to join Mario during the next break, which will be after the following how-to session. So let's move to the next one. Thank you, Mario, again.
Okay. See you later. Thanks, guys. Take care. Ciao.